Second Star Wars stories. She flew crying as he was picked up hands and jaws, and a proud neck was humbled to lie like dirty linen in a coarse washing bag. And students, listen here. Now in first stanza, we learned about the male Sanskrit word. In second stanza, poet has described about the situation of female Sanskrit word, who happened to be the life partner of this male Sanskrit word. And she is now flying in the sky on the above the same spot where the dead body of male Sanskrit bird is lying on the earth. So this female Sanskrit bird is seeing the dead body of male's, her life partner, male Sanskrit bird. And she is also seeing those hunters, okay, who shot her life partner. And what they are doing with the dead body of this male Sanskrit bird, they are handling the dead body of male Sanskrit bird, means they are picking up dead body of male Sanskrit bird by its hands and jaws. Its hands and jaws, students, they are, you know, picking the dead body of students. I mean, see how cruel they are. Okay, and some time ago, this male Sanskrit bird's neck was, you know, proud. You remember in first stanza, this male Sanskrit bird was trying to pull the sun, reluctant sun, out of rim of its horizon. Now that neck, it was caged at that time. Okay, but after its death, what happened? It is not stretched anymore. It is lifeless. Okay, and it was proud neck that time. But now it is being humiliated, humbled, insulted by these hunters. They are picking its body by hands and jaws. They are, and because of this, and you know, while picking up its body by hands and jaws, the bird's neck is also humiliated, humbled, insulted. Okay, and how it is now? it's like a proud neck was humbled to lie like dirty linen in a coarse washing bag. Means they picked up this male Sanskrit bird by hands and jaws, and then they threw this beautiful dead body of the male Sanskrit bird. Okay, like a, they are treating dead body of male Sanskrit bird like, you know, something dirty linen cloth. Linen is a kind of a cloth. It's a, you must have seen linen cloth, you know, you wear also. It's a smooth, glossy, shining cloth. That kind of, you know, cloth is called linen cloth. So this proud neck of male Sanskrit bird is treated like a dirty linen cloth, and then these hunters have thrown it in a coarse washing bag. Coarse means rough washing bag. Okay, now third stanza. She circled the sky in movements of grace over his disgraceful end. The killers went away and she returned to the death scene with grief that inscribed its intensity in dots and pits, like the Morse code of world sorrow transmitted to the air. Now students, this female Sanskrit bird, she is watching all this, the dead body of her life partner, male Sanskrit bird, and those hunters, how they are handling, okay, the dead body of her life partner, like picking him up by hands and jaws, and then how they are, you know, throwing its beautiful body in that rough, coarse washing bag. All this she is, you know, watching. And she is not coming down immediately. Why? Because hunters are there. That is why she is just, you know, flying. She is circling the sky, that spot. Okay, above that spot, she is circling in the sky. And she is crying also. She is very sad also by seeing, you know, the death of her life partner, male Sanskrit bird. The killers went away and she returned to the death scene with grief that inscribed its intensity in dots and pits. And when these killers, these hunters, went away from that place, okay, with the dead body of her life partner, male Sanskrit bird, she came down, okay, She came down and she was in so much pain and sadness. Okay, here students, her sadness is, you know, inscribed. Inscribed means carved, okay, written or compared or described. Okay, her sadness is described with the intensity in dots and pits. Means intensity of her grief, of her sadness is described in dots and pits, like the Morse code of bird sorrow transmitted to the air. Dear students, here Morse code, okay, its Morse code is a symbolic language invented by Samuel F. D. Morse. You can see this description or definition in glossary part. Okay, so it's a symbolic language invented that uses a combination of long and short sounds or flashes of light for sending messages. And so students, especially army or navy, okay, these people, soldiers, they use this Morse code to send, you know, messages. And in that messages, however, is the code, it's a combination of long and short sounds, sometimes flashes. So here in this stanza, okay, intensity of female sunscreen birds, okay, sadness means she is making sound while crying. What kind of sound she is making? Short and long sounds she is making. And her intensity of, and the intensity of her sadness is described in dots and pits like the Morse code.